Students, in the last class we have studied the volume of cuboid and volume of cube. Volume of cuboid is given by the formula V is equal to L into B into H, and volume of the cube is given by as L, B, H are same, and if we consider one side of the cube as A, then it is a cube. So these are the two formulas we learned, and we did two problems, exercise problems, and I have given third problem as home assignment. If you tried it, it is very good. Check your answer. Those who not tried, if you don't know, see how to solve this problem. What is the third problem? A cuboidal vessel, the vessel is of the shape cuboid, okay, cuboidal vessel, 10 meter long and 8 meter wide. So length is 10 meter, breadth is 8 meter. How high must it be made? High means here height, how much height it should have that vessel, so that it will hold 380 cubic meters. Instead of writing a meter cube, they have written in the words cubic meter. That is nothing but its volume. How much the capacity of that container is nothing but the volume of that particular vessel to hold the liquid. If you put the liquid in that vessel, how much liquid you can have, that is the capacity. It is nothing but its volume of the cuboid. Say how much volume it has got, that much liquid it can hold. So our work is to find the height of that vessel. Length is given, breadth is given, volume also given. We have to find the height. Okay, so what are the given? We have to write in the statement form. Length of the cuboidal vessel. I will write it here. We need place to work out. I will write here vessel. L is equal to, symbol is very important in all the formulas, same symbol we have to use. L is equal to, long means length, okay, 10 meter, that is given. Next, what we know, wide is nothing but breadth. It's a breadth. Symbol for breadth is B is equal to, next one, which is the value we are given, 8 meter wide, it's breadth. We don't know the height, that we have to find how high. So that we have to find. Instead, we know it can hold 380 cubic meters of liquid. Capacity of the liquid is nothing but volume of that container. Volume of the vessel. Symbol V is equal to, that also know, it is 380 cubic meter. Cubic meter can be written as meter cube or cubic meter. It is one and the same. Therefore, height of the vessel. Symbol for height, small letter H is equal to how much meter we have to find out. Now, which formula we have to use now? It is for cuboid. This formula we have to use. Volume of the cuboid. So, figure is cuboid here. So, this formula we have to use. The solid is in the shape of cuboid. So, V is equal to L into B into H. Now, which value you know? Substitute this value in the formula and simplify to get the unknown value. Now, V value is known now. It is 380 cubic meter, then equal sign, L is known, it is 10 meter, into breadth also known, it is 8 meter, into height we don't know, so we have to write H only. h. Now we want h, so bring all the values to this side. Then we get the, after simplification, we'll get the answer. Now this all into 10 into h, 8 into h. So into, if you bring this other side of the equal sign, the operation is reversed. So into will change into divide. So 380 is already there, right, as it is. It is divided by 10 into 8. One time if you bring 10 into 10, it will divide by 10. Then one time 8 if you bring next time, it is also divided by 8. So both are in the denominator. Since they are 10 into 8, 80. It is a single number, so into only, in between these two, okay? It won't become divide. Now it, this side it will get h only. Now 10 table, 10 ones are 10, 38. So 0 you can divide. Then 8 table, 8 or you can write 38 by 8, h is equal to, or you can write in the decimal form, 8 table, 8 fours are 32, 8 fours are 32, 6 remaining, 38 minus 32 is 6 remaining, so there is no digit, point you have to write, then 0 you have to take, so 60, 8, 6 are 60, 8 sevens are 56, 60 is reminder, 6 reminder, so 60 means 8, 7s are 56, 60 minus 56 is 4, 40, 8 5s are 40, so it will divide 4.75 when you divide by 8, so height is 4.75 meter, I hope at least few of you got this answer, okay, if everyone got, very good. This home assignment. Next, we'll move on to the next problem, fourth problem. See in your textbook, fourth problem. Find the cost of fourth problem. Find the cost of, find the cost of digging a cuboidal, digging a cuboidal, cuboidal, digging a cuboidal pit. Pit they have to construct, so they want to dig it. How much measurement? 8 meter long, 8 meter long, 6 meter broad, 6 meter broad, 6 meter broad, and 3 meter deep, and 3 meter deep, at the rate of, at the rate of rupees 30 per meter cube, they want to construct one pit. Its shape is cuboidal shape and its measurement is all given, length, breadth, height. Deep is here, usually pit will won't mention height of the pit, instead we'll use the depth, the deep. So deep or depth is nothing but the height, okay. So length, breadth, height is given, 8 meter length, 6 meter breadth and 3 meter depth, height. Now the rate is given, rate means cost. If you want to dig 1 meter cube volume, that much area, if the pit occupies, you want to dig it, you have to pay the worker rupees 30, okay. So in that rate, using this rate, you have to pay after construction of this pit, of the, having this measurement, it is little bigger, so more you have to pay. Exactly how much we have to pay, we have to calculate, got it. Now given values, we will write one by one, and what is not known or what we have to find out, it will come at the last, we will find out. Okay. Now, which are the values we know? Length of the cuboidal pit. For length, what measurement will take? Symbol L is equal to 8 meter long, that is length. Next statement, breadth of the cuboidal pit. Breadth of the cuboidal pit. Symbol is B is equal to 6 meter broad. So 6 meter. Then height is given, depth is nothing but depth, we have to write height here. Height of the cuboidal pit, symbol is H is equal to how much? It is 3 meter. Now, how much area you have to dig it? The space you have to dig it in the ground is nothing but the volume that particular pit. So we have to find the volume. Therefore, volume of the cuboidal pit. Symbol B is equal to, first step we'll find the volume, then we find the cost. Okay. Now again, since it is cuboid shape, we have to use the formula B is equal to L into B into H, length into breadth into height. That formula we have to use. So we substitute the value. We know, don't know now, write V as it is. Length is 8 into breadth is 6 into height is 3 into 3. So V is equal to 8 sixa, how much? 48. If you multiply this, you will get 48 into 3. V is equal to 48 into 3. 3 into 48. 3 8s are 24. Right? 2 in hand. 3 4s are 12 plus 2. 14. So it is 144. No, don't write meter. Volume always a cubic meter. Cube it is. Meter cube. So this is the this much space in the ground we have to empty it, dig it, so that we can make the pit. Now we have to pay now. Okay. So rate or cost I will write a cost of digging one meter cube ground. How much? Rupees 30. Cost of digging a 1 meter cube ground. Now, therefore, cost of digging. Now, what is the area of that pit? Sorry, volume. Volume of the pit is how much? Not 1 meter cube. We have to dig 144 meter cube. So now it is not 1. Now it is 144 meter cube ground. How much we have to pay? It is rupees. Now we'll find out. Meter cube rupees, right? 1 meter cube you have to pay 30 rupees after digging. Now it is 144 meter cube earth we have to dig. How much we have to pay? Question mark. Now cross multiply these two number together in the numerator, these two. This is single number, there is no other number. So single number always written in the denominator. Okay, here it is 144 into 30 divided by 1. So 3 4s are 12, 1 in hand, 3 4s are 12 plus 1, 13, and again 1 in hand, 3 1s are 3 plus 1, wait, 3 4s are 12, 1 in hand, 3 4s are 12, 1 plus 1, 13, 3, 1 in hand, 3 1s are 3 plus 1, 4. Then 1 0 is there, right? 0 divided by 1. And whenever any number divided by 1 is nothing but same, it is this much, 4320 rupees. So it is rupees 4320 they have to pay as the charge, the cost, or the this rupees they have to pay after digging the earth. Okay, got it? Okay, one more we will work out. See the fifth problem. The capacity of a cuboidal tank, fifth problem, the capacity of a cuboidal tank is 50,000 liters. Liters of water. So this 50,000 liters of water a tank can hold. Now what is your work? Find the breadth of the tank. Find the breadth. Find the breadth of the tank. If its length and depth are respectively 2.5 meter and 10 meter. What we have to do in this problem? The capacity of a cuboidal tank. Capacity is one big tank we have. We have to fill it with water. We know how much it will fill with water. Its capacity is 50,000 liters. 50,000 liters of water you can have it in that tank when it is completely filled. That is its capacity. Now that particular tank which is used to fill the water, its breadth we don't know. That we have to find out. That is the question. Now what is other values are given related to tank? It is its length is given and depth is given. Here depth of the tank is nothing but its height. We won't in a case of any this one tank or the well, whatever we will use. Usually we will use the word depth instead of height. Okay. So it is nothing but height. So length is given, height is given respectively. Length is 2.5 meter, that tank length is 2.5, and its depth 10 meter depth it is deep. Its breadth we don't know. That tank breadth we don't know. That we have to find out. Okay. So what is given? Volume of the or capacity which is nothing but the volume of the cuboidal tank V explain, I will write cuboidal tank V is equal to 50,000 liters L liters. Now the all the values is in meters, so we have to change this into meters. Now one thousand liters is equal to 1 meter cube. That one, the previous problem we have studied, 1000 liter is exactly equal to 1 meter cube. Therefore volume of cuboidal tank, volume of the tank is V is equal to, now instead of 50,000, it's changed into now 1 meter cube, liters meter cube. 1000 liter is equal to 1 meter cube. 1000 or 10,000? Wait 1 minute. 1000, yes. 1000 liter is equal to 1 meter cube. Now 50,000 liter is equal to how much meter cube? Okay. Now cross multiply these two number together, divide by this single number. So it is 50,000 into 1 by 1000. So divide by 1000, you'll get 50. So it is 50 meter cube vessel. Yeah, volume of the tank is 50 meter cube. Now length is given. Length of the tank, symbol L is equal to how much length, respectively length is this much, 2.5 meter, breadth is B is equal to, that is also given, it is how much here, 10 meter. Therefore the depth in the bracket, height of the tank, h is equal to how much. What is the formula? Since it is cuboid, same formula we have to use. Cuboid, volume V is equal to length into breadth into height. Volume is how much? We change it into meter cube. So it is 50 is equal to length is how much? It is 2.5 into breadth is how much? 10 meter into height. Okay. Now height we want, into value if you bring this side it will change into divide, so it is 50 already is there, by to this number we have to divide 2.5 into 10 is equal to height. 50 divided by 2.5 into 10 is 25 into 10 is 250. Since point is there after digit here, decimal point, one digit is there to a right. So after one digit, right, put the point into this much, is equal to h. So it is 50 divided by 25. 50 divided by 25. 25 ones are, 25 twos are. So h is nothing but now how much we got? We got 2. H is equal to 2, so it is 2 meter. That is the answer. So the height of that tank should be 2 meter. That is the answer for fifth problem. I hope you understood today's formula and today's problems, how to do. the remaining three problems we will do in the next class. Okay, meanwhile learn all the formulas, and exam is coming nearby. You go through the chapters, the previous exercise, and study it, practice it for the upcoming FA3 exam. Thank you, children.